All right, guys, welcome to another training on this channel. In this short training, I'm going to show you how to use FTP clients like Filezilla to upload files to your server. It's one of the best ways to upload files to your server, especially if you're dealing with very large files. It's always advisable. I always find it very easier to use File Manager within my cPanel. But when I'm dealing with very large files, I always use Filezilla. So I'm going to show you how to use Filezilla, and that's what we're going to cover in this training. So now let's get started. All right, guys, so like I said before, I always use File Manager when I log into my cPanel to upload files most of the time when I'm dealing with small files, you know, themes, plugins, and all that. But when I'm dealing with large files, I always use Filezilla. So I always go to my login to your cPanel, go to File Manager. You can always locate your domain, and you can see these are some of the files that you can easily upload inside cPanel. All you need to just click on Upload, and then locate the file on your system, select the file, and upload your file. But like I said, if you're dealing with very large file, you can always use Filezilla. So if you Google Filezilla, you can see it's a free open source application, FTP client for uploading files. And there are two types. We have the Filezilla client, and then we have the Filezilla server. So the one we're going to be using definitely is the Filezilla client. So do not download the Filezilla server. So you go for the Filezilla client for Windows, and all you need to do is click to download. And of course, we have the three types. So the free ones is okay for all that we need. SFTP, you can download from Google Drive and all that. So just download, and then you just install it like every other software. So you click on Next, and continue to download it. Next, desktop icon, next, and then you can decline that, and if you like, you can. So the next thing is just finish, and now it's installed on your system, and this is the interface. So all you need to do is log in the same way you log into your cPanel with your host, the username, the password, the ports, and then you just log in, just same way you log in. And if you look at the URL of your cPanel, that's going to be the hosting host name. So that's going to be the URL to your cPanel. So you need to, and you can click on Site Manager and add your site, but most of the time I don't do that. So I just go straight adding the host or the URL, the basic URL of your cPanel, then the username. And there are two ways to log in. We have the FTP, you can use the FTP protocol, and then you can use the SFTP protocol. The FTP protocol is just like your HTTP when you log into your website on, and the port for that is 21. And then we have the SFTP, which corresponds to your HTTPS, and the port for that is 21098. Those are the things that you should be familiar with. FTP colon double slash, then the URL of your website, then port is 21, or SFTP colon double slash, then the port will be 21098. So I use either of the two, my username and my password, but we're going to use FTP. It doesn't really matter, so just add in FTP and then the port 21, and then you paste in URL business up to .com, just URL, the basic URL, and then you go, and then after you paste it there, and then username, get your username and your password to your cPanel, and click on quick connect, and of course it's going to establish that connection and connect you to your server. And you can see on the left you have the files on your system, everything you have on your system document, and on the right we have the files on your hosting account, the cPanel. So Everything on the left is on your system. Everything on the right is your server. So, and just like you will open, upload files here, you the same way you go to Filezilla, you upload files same way, except on Filezilla, you drag from left to right. So like this NetPlus system, I'm going to add some files to that domain. So click on NetPlus system, and then you can see all the same files that we have in the cPanel is the same file that you can see in Filezilla. It's basically the same thing. And just like you would click on upload, you will just drag files from left, and then you drag to right, and everything will be uploaded. So let me try and upload these files. And there are two ways to do that. I could right click and click on upload, or I could just select all and drag and drop on the right hand side. It's the same thing, and then it will start connecting, and everything that I've dragged will be uploaded. And if you confirm in cPanel reload, you will see that those files that are uploaded in cPanel can be seen in File Manager in on that domain. It's basically as easy as that. And if I'm working with any website, say let's say I'm working on my WordPress website, so let me look for my netplustraining.com and just show you something. If I'm working with very large files, if you go to NetPlus Training, WP Contents, which represent the WT content in your cPanel, and then you can see the plugins and the theme. If I click on plugins, and it will show the plugins that are already on that on NetPlus system. So I could just find a plugin on my website, on my system, right click and upload, or drag and drop in that plugin folder in the plugin in the content WP content folder for that NetPlus training. And if I confirm in cPanel, you can see it's been added, and then all I need to do is just extract the plugin and then start using the plugin. So it's advisable. Normally, you will, if you're using Filezilla, you still have to extract in on cPanel. So just right click and then extract files, and it will be extracted. And then you can refresh, and then you can see it's been extracted. You can see vid adds, and if you like, you can just delete the main file. And that is it. So large files you should upload in Filezilla. It's a very easy way to upload and use Filezilla. So sometimes when I'm trying to upload very large files like themes and all that, I use Filezilla. And then the same way, you click on themes and then you can see all the themes that you have already on that domain. And you can just drag any theme from your system that you have anywhere in your system. You drag it, you upload it to your file manager, and you have it. So that's how easy it is to use Filezilla FTP clients. So in the description, I'm going to have the host for both the FTP and the port for that, and then the SFTP and the port for that. So you can use any one of the two to log in to Filezilla. So thank you for watching this video, and please subscribe and don't forget to turn on your notification. Thank you and bye bye.